Hi, I'm Paul Battaglia, and this is section 5.4, Sum and Difference Formulas. You know, one of the ways I like to begin section 5.4 is actually by listing all of the sum and difference formulas that we'll be using, but then I like to put my students at ease. And the way I do that is to tell them that the first thing that they don't have to worry about is memorizing all the formulas. Now, that's a personal preference, and you might not wish to do so, but the reason I do it is simply because we live in an age and in a world where they can easily access that information should they need it. So from my perspective, I really want them to be able to work with the formulas, know how to use them, and when to use them. Now, to that end, I have Gabe and Brittany here with me, and they're going to help us kind of talk to you about how to structure a lesson to get students engaged in sum and difference formulas. So, Brittany, talk to us a little bit about what you want students to work with first.
Well, when they're using the sum and difference formulas, I want them to be able to use degrees and radians.
Okay.
So that way we're pulling from previous sections. So,
yeah. And then what about if they're a little bit concerned about their choices of angles, you know, what would you tell them then?
That you can do whatever you would like. There are different options. So a student might have something with adding and another one might have subtracting.
Right, so they don't have to feel kind of like pigeonholed into just, well, I have to use the sum formula only.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Perfect. Gabe, you know, tell to us a little bit about the idea of evaluating let's say sine of 105 degrees. What do we want students to think about in a situation like that?
So something about that is we can actually find that exact value of sine of 105 degrees. But students don't recognize 105 as being one of the angles which they see on the unit circle.
Okay.
I mean, it is on the unit circle, but they don't recognize it from what they know on the unit circle.
Okay.
So what we can do is we can have this conversation about, well, can we use these sum and difference formulas to actually find the exact value of sine of 105 degrees?
Okay.
And normally the conversation goes on for a little bit, and eventually we come to a point where a student will say, well, 105 degrees is 60 degrees plus 45 degrees.
Perfect. Okay.
And then, or we can take that along with what Brittany was saying, and the student can say, well, 105 might also be 150 minus 45
degrees. Right, you have options,
plenty
of options.
So yeah, so there's plenty of different ways to actually find this value.
Okay.
And then we can use these formulas to actually go ahead and actually find the exact value of sine of 105 degrees.
Good. Talk to me a little bit more about the idea of exact value, because I know that my students, they'll glance right over that phrase, sometimes I've even seen them grab their calculator and they'll say, sine of 105 degrees, okay, let me just type that in, and they'll, 0.97, and I tell them, well, that's not exact, and then if they really kind of want to be smart about it, they'll say, oh, I'm sorry, 0.966, and they'll just keep reading on their calculator, and I have to explain to them that that's really still a truncated value. So talk to us a little bit more about what they should be doing to get that exact value.
Yeah, exactly. Students, for some reason, might see this problem and say, I can compute sine of 105, plug it in their calculator, say it's about 0.97.
Right.
But it's that about word right there
that I
just said. It's about 0.97.
Right, right.
And then even if they give you 100 decimal places, it's still not an exact value, because what they're going to end up with is this irrational number.
Okay.
And they could spend their whole life trying to write out this, number for you, but they're never going to make it. So what I suggest to students is what we really want to do is we want to somehow write this number in terms of maybe radicals, maybe fractions, and tie it back to the idea that if we use the sum and difference formula, we can do that. It might take a couple steps, but we can eventually get there.
Mm-hmm. Perfect, perfect. I hope these tips have been helpful for you, and you find much success in section 5.4.